we have to illustrate just how legislators are fighting back against the right wing when it comes to all the wiener legislation. Are we going to call it that? Well, I don't know. I mean, these guys, they get their Cialis and they get their Viagra all covered for insurance, and they do not have erectile dysfunction, which hits about 40% of men over the age of 60 or something. I don't know. But there are guys that go get this stuff when they don't need it. And so to illustrate the absurdity and to fight back and just, you know, make the men go through the same thing, there's a number of legislators who are introducing stuff, and we'll introduce them to you tonight on The Ed Show on MSNBC. You know, hell, we're adding jobs. We've saved the automobile industry. Onward and upward. Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire Radio host, good to have you with us.
How are you today?
I'm doing good. Head north.
Oh, kind of.
Well, this is the world the Republicans want to live in. That's fine. I hope that people out there understand that we are where we are because of the obstruction and the heavy-handedness in Washington. Had they allowed Sandra Fluck to testify, none of this would have taken place. It was the heavy-handedness of Daryl Issa.
Yeah, this is...
So now it's gotten Limbaugh into all kinds of quagmires. He says it's like losing a few French fries, but he's now lost 45 national and local companies. It's so bad for him, the American Heart Association doesn't even want their PSAs in his show.
Yeah, that's a lot worse than French fries. What this story has done, and you've seen it happen so many times, is one story emerges, and then people start looking at the back stories. And now the back stories have the old stories coming up where things like where Rush Limbaugh ridiculed children who were relying on school meals, and he said they ought to be dumpster divers. They ought to dine in the dumpsters. Matter of fact, on one of his shows, Ed, he went in as far as saying that there's been a video produced that'll show you how to healthfully dine on dumpster food. That's what he was telling children when they were talking about a children meals program. He goes on to talk about children who receive – this is a different time. He says children who receive free school meals are wanton waifs, serfs who are wards of the state, and we have to take care of them. But the point being is this started off as a story about a caveman whose teeny-weeny club didn't work because all he does is talks anger about women, hateful about women, and we all know what that means. A guy that doubts his masculinity, his virility, is exactly what we expect. But then this has turned into another story. And the other story is we're going back and we're looking at some of the other things he said where he says this thing about, well, you know, women, I don't know if you saw this quote, but I've gone back and looked at it. I said this has caused me and a lot of other people throughout the country to dig into these stories and figure out what's happened here. But you go back and it looks where he calls Kelsey, he says Chelsea Clinton, 13-year-old child. He calls her the White House dog, and he thinks that's funny. And all his listeners, yuck, yuck, it's funny. This is the kind of thing we think is great. But we're starting to see what he's about, where he says feminism was established to allow unattractive women access to mainstream America. Once we start looking behind this, we understand this isn't just just this man who's in some kind of sexual quagmire, some sexual chaos. This isn't just about a man who's coming down from OxyContin and suffering from delirium tremens. This is a lot more serious. And what it shows, we're getting that image of who he really is, and it's still there, Ed. I mean, this week he says Tracy McMillan is overeducated because she wants to do a film, wants to write a book. She's a typical overeducated liberal woman, and it ties into the old quote where he says that all feminists, we should reject all feminists because they're not warm and cuddly. So the more you get to see this guy, the more you understand, and the more you say, okay, I'm an advertiser, and I'm going to stick with him. And not expect this to. I'll tell you something. My wife, if she's watched this story, my wife is furious. My wife is saying, "Let me get this right. Who is advertising with him? And if it's a grocery I'm gonna buy, I'm not gonna buy it anymore. If it's a service I'm supposed to buy, I'm not gonna do it anymore. So who's he stuck with? He's developed this sleazy, deviant old white guy porn crowd type of advertiser. I don't know if you followed this. His new advertiser, for example, is Ashley Madison. Okay, these are people who want to advertise with him, and
are they absolutely on the air with
him? No, but they're trying to, and Limbaugh's trying to say, oh no, we don't know if we want to go with them. We're not sure we want to go with them, but he went with somebody just like him. He went with another crew that is the whole purpose of the organization is to find a sugar daddy. It's just he understands that right now what he's left with is a new radio porno site. That's what he's going to be left, because in his heart, that's what he is. In his heart, he is the sleazy, old, deviant white guy whose club doesn't work anymore, and this is what he wants to attract. And I promise you, if you're an advertiser right now and you haven't gone back and looked at the stories where he says women like male chauvinist pigs like me because I have great appeal. I mean, there's story after story that now are emerging that weren't out there before, Ed. And I think that's what's so critical about what's happening here. This isn't just about the story about Fluke anymore. Now we're trying to go back and we're trying to analyze who is this guy.
What do you say to those that say, well, it's freedom of speech?
Well, I say, you know
and,
what?
And Sarah Palin went down that road, and so has Michelle Bachmann.
Well, they have to, Ed. You know what? They have to. There's no. This is not freedom of speech. What we're seeing is not freedom of speech. What we're seeing is the heart of speech that comes from the Republican Party. This doesn't have anything to do with freedom. This has to do with victimizing people. This has to do with accusatory language. This has to do with what the new Republican Party is. And by God, I've said it so many times, and I can't stop saying it. If you're carrying around a damn Republican registration, a voter registration card, you are the new Republican Party, and Rush Limbaugh is your spokesman. And if you're an advertiser sticking with this guy, there's no excuse. This is not about freedom of speech.
What do you make of Mitt Romney not willing to make a definitive statement?
Here it is.
I know there's a connection between him and his old buddies at Bain that now own the syndication company and everything else. But isn't this beyond that?
It is.
He's got all kinds of money. Beyond that, isn't this a question about character and Romney being out of touch and not understanding the severity of it?
Axelrod had it right, Ed. Axelrod comes out and says, look, this isn't a guy that even has enough backbone to stand up for women and children. This is a guy who understands that Rush Limbaugh, the guy that he won't speak out against, said that poor children should have to find their food in a damn dumpster.
Here's Romney on weighing in on the drugster.
My campaign is about jobs and the economy and scaling back the size of government, and I'm not going to weigh in on that particular controversy.
He just will not go against the voice of the Republican Party. Here's Axelrod.
These are tests. Presidential campaigns are tests. You're tested every single day in different ways. The Limbaugh thing was a test of leadership, and you have them all the time. And, Mitt Romney's failed those tests in the campaign.
Do you agree with him on that?
Of course. This is a hard. Yeah. Look, the Bain cap, that's a minor issue. It is that this man does not have a backbone. Do you realize today's story is being carried where Mitt Romney's wife is talking about she has to be the voice that talks to women for Mitt Romney. She has to be his surrogate voice for women because he's so incapable of relating to any part of the human condition. And the human condition is we have to be able to talk, we have to take care of each other, we have to stand up for each other, and we damn sure have to stand up and stand against a man who tells his listeners, and they laugh about it, that poor children should find their food in a dumpster, that they should have to go dumpster diving, and if they don't know how to do it, he'll produce a video and give it to them. This has gone way beyond the story about Fluke right now. And I just can't say it enough. If you're an advertiser and you think that this is your voice, and you think this is your language, you're an embarrassment. How do you go home and even speak to your children? How do you do that?
Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host. You hear him on weekends across America on Progressive Talk radio stations. Mike Papantonio, great to have you with us.
Thank
Ring
you,
of
Ed.
Fire radio show. Thank you so much.